Ladies and gentlemen, you think Passata Day is such a busy, long, stressful day? No! You can make passata at home in 1 hour or even less, and I'll show you how. I made 3 easy bottles today by myself. I had fun, the music was on, and I'm gonna share this with you. I've just called Nonna in Italy and I'm gonna ask her how to make the perfect tomato sauce. Allora, Nonna, buongiorno!
Buongiorno, Nonna!
Tutto bene?
Tutto bene, grazie. Voi state bene?
Io oggi sto facendo il pomodoro, la passata fatta in casa, ma poca, 5 kg di sugo, 5 kg di pomodoro. Qual è il segreto per fare un buon pomodoro, una buona passata?
Ci vuole tanto amore, tanta passione. E tanta voglia di farlo, perché se no non si fa niente.
va bene. Sì, sì, ok, allora ti faccio sapere come va. Grazie, saluta a tutti, nonna, saluta a tutti, saluta.
C'è tutto a posto, ciao.
Ciao, ciao. Hi and welcome to Vincenzo's Plate, the place where you get to learn how to cook fantastic Italian dishes. Now, I've learned how to make passata from my nonna. You can watch the video on my Facebook page, how nonna does it now by herself. I've done a video with Filippo, the master of tomatoes, and he shows how he does it. So I've combined nonna and Filippo style, and I made it at home. Small batch, just for me and my family, and it's so easy to do. So let's learn how to do it at home, in the easy, easy, easy way. To make passata at home, so easy, so easy. So what I've got here is 5 kilos of beautiful Roma tomatoes. They are the best one for a passata, unless you can get some marzano. I'm gonna use 1 capsicum, pepper in America. Now, it's my fault, I was meant to get a green one. That's what my grandmother uses, because it's sweet and it gives the extra flavor to the tomato. I use red, use green, please. A nice bunch of basil. We want to have about 2 tablespoons of rock salt. We need some glass bottles here, okay? Just use the glass bottles that you have from passatas that you buy from the shop, or you can buy small ones. Now, if you have a small family, you just get a small one and it will be enough for a meal. Extra virgin olive oil. And then we need a nice large pot where we can cook the tomatoes. We need colanders because we are at home, so it's the easiest thing to use. And the most important thing to use is this. We call this passa patate. I think in English it's called vegetable meal. You know, you put potatoes in here and it mash it for you, you know, or any vegetables. In this case, the tomatoes. See, the tomato come from this, come out from this, and we get the juice. What we want to do first is to put them in water. So what we do is we clean them a little bit. Then what we do is we remove the green part, okay? This is what Filippo taught me when I did a video with him. Cut the green part because you don't want that flavor from the green part. We got the tomato enough and we just put it in a pot, okay? Because we're gonna cook them soon. So remove the green part. Cut enough. How beautiful they are. And put it in the pot. So yeah, it is a process, guys, but that's what we need to do. Now, see this one's got a little bit of black. I don't want that. I don't want to use this part, so we remove it. Okay, so we remove the top part. Cut this enough. And here we have it. Like, see now when you open, you can see this one is a little bit black. I don't want to use it. So remove what you don't like from the tomato. Now, probably this is the most time-consuming part because the rest is so much fun that you won't be counting the time. You won't be counting any time. This is something I learned from my friend Filippo when we made the sauce together. I'm gonna put 1/2 bottle of water, passata bottle, in there. So basically, the tomatoes are not gonna stick to the bottom of the pan, thanks to the water. Just 1/2, just like that. Now, with the capsicum, what Nonna likes to do, it's just to add a little bit, okay? So we're gonna use only 1/2 of a capsicum because I'm only making 5 kilos. So what we do is we remove all the seeds. We don't want to put the seeds in the tomato sauce. And then what we do is we cut into strips, just like this. Yummy. And we put it in the tomatoes, okay? Just like that. Mix, so they go everywhere. What the capsicum is going to do, or the pepper, is going to give extra flavor to these beautiful tomatoes. You don't have to use it. This is something that Nonna does, and I love Nonna sauce, so why not to do it? And now we can go and boil it. All right, now we're gonna cook the tomatoes for about 20 to 25 minutes, okay? What we do is every 5 minutes, we want to go and stir, okay? Now, what we want to do is we want to get the water out of the tomatoes because we only want the juice from the tomatoes, okay? So that's what we do. We are getting rid of the water. Okay, guys, it's time to turn the tomatoes around. Nice smell. And guess what? The capsicum takes over. I can smell the capsicum. Oh, what a strong smell. Beautiful tomatoes. Here we go. Just turn them around. Look how beautiful this is. Okay, guys, we have 3 more minutes to go, and then we're ready to start getting the juice out of these tomatoes. Now, this is what we're gonna do, okay? What we're gonna do here is we're gonna get a colander, put it in a bowl, and now I have to be careful not to stain my shirt. We just go like this. Oh, my shirt is about to get dirty. Just go like that. Here we go. The water has the acidity level that we don't want. We don't want the acidity. We want to get rid of the acidity. Come on, water, get out. We don't want you. We don't want you right now. Leave us, please, leave us. Now, once the water is out, we're gonna put the tomatoes in a larger bowl. If you find more water, look at the water there, get rid of it. We don't want the water. Now, let's throw this water in the sink and do another batch of tomatoes so we get more water out. Here we go. Beautiful. Now, let's put the tomatoes now through the pasta patate, the vegetable meal. Now, this is where the magic begins. We have the pasta patate here waiting for the tomatoes. So I'm gonna get a spoon with holes, get my tomatoes, put them in there. And the capsicum, don't forget. Because this is the moment where the capsicum mixes with the tomatoes. Okay, and look at the sauce that we get now. Look at the sauce that we get, look at the sauce. Can you see the sauce coming out? Can you see the passata coming out? That's passata, ladies and gentlemen. That's passata for you guys. This is what you want to achieve. This is what you want to achieve when you make passata. Look at the juice, look at the beautiful juice. As I'm doing this, there's more water coming out. We don't want that water, okay? We do not want the water. Please, water, leave us. We don't want you. Do you understand? We don't want you, okay? And here we go. Yum. Can you see here, I've got so much tomatoes in there, way too much. So what we do is, let's put them in here for now. And we will get back to this, okay, after. Because I want to get more juice out of this. And look what's happening at the bottom here. Look at what we get. So this is what we get. And we put it in the massive bowl. This is the polpa of the tomato. Still moist, still wet in there, which means there's still lots of juice to come out, see? Right, let's keep going until the tomato becomes dry. I know it's work, it's exercise. You don't need to go to the gym. Yeah, they look nice and moist. I think we should be able to get more juice out of this. Of course, we're doing this by hand, so it's a bit more difficult. If I had a machine, like the one that Filippo has or Nonna, would be so much easier to get the juice out. Okay, let's keep going. You want love? You need to give love to them. Oh yeah. Look at that. That's the last bit that we have. And nothing goes to waste, guys. Nothing. A passata. It's almost ready. Beautiful. Guys, I'm still okay. I'm not dirty. We got one more thing to do. Adding extra flavor in this, okay? This is something I got from Philippe, okay? We're gonna put 1 tablespoon of rock salt. This is still nice and hot, so the salt will melt. We mix now. We mix. Beautiful. We smell. And it smells like real tomatoes. And what we do now, we're gonna put it in the bottle. Okay, so now I'm gonna show you what to do with the bottles. Okay, now here we have the bottles. I've got milk bottles here with a nice lid, you know, to seal it. What we do, this is something I learned from Filippo. Nonna doesn't actually do this. We get fresh basil and we put it at the bottom. Now, I like this Filippo technique simply because it does give beautiful, beautiful flavors to the tomatoes. I know not every Italian family does it, so you can do what you want, but you should trust Filippo. This is a really, really good technique. Now, what I'm gonna do, which is easier, if you have a funnel, you can go straight into the bowl. I don't have a funnel with me today. Yeah, no, it's interesting, I don't have a funnel. So what I do is I just put the sauce in here. And then we transfer the sauce into the bottle. All right, what we wanna do now, you can use the funnel of this. We're gonna actually put the tomato sauce in the bottle. It goes inside the bottle. Go inside, please. Go inside. Nice and thick, just the way I want it. And we're gonna stop just here. We're gonna stop here. Okay, now I only made a small batch and I'm gonna eat them in no time, okay? But if you make a large batch, what the extra virgin olive oil does is secure your tomato sauce. We're gonna boil the bottles now, which we're going to secure and seal the bottles, but the oil, it's an extra help to secure your tomato sauce. Okay, you don't have to use it if you don't want to. Now we put the lid on, and very, very tight. All right, here it is, okay? First bottle is done. Now let's do a bigger bottle here. And the bigger bottle should waste less. Yeah, everything goes in. Look how beautiful it is. Everything's going inside. Look at that, look at that, look at that. Look how beautiful this is. Oh, it is delicious, fantastic. See guys, it's always good to leave this room here so we give enough room to the bottle to be sealed. So when we boil it, we can seal it. Look how nice it is. Oh, look at the seeds, look at the basil. Oh guys, come on. This is what you want. Here we go. Let's do this bottle. Oh, come on, come on, come on. We wanna fill this up. Come on, 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 come on. Yay! Yay! Guys, we did 3 bottles. 3 bottles with 5 kilos of tomatoes. Look at that. Extra virgin olive oil. Put the lid on. Ready? Uno, due, tre. Ah, nice and sealed. And here we go, guys. Look. Look how beautiful tomatoes. Here we have our homemade tomatoes made with love. In 1 hour and 10 minutes, you can make passata. Yes, it's only 3 bottles, but you made it. It's not the one you buy from the shop. Look how real this is. Lots of seeds in these tomatoes, but hey, they're delicious. Look at that. Oh my God. I don't know why I put it in the bottle. I actually can have this right away. How can you not make a pasta right now, huh? And the best part is, look, I didn't get dirty, look. Look how clean I am. Can you believe it? I'm a little bit dirty here because I think I was just on the table now and I stained my shirt, but look, clean job. You can do it if your friends come and see you on a Sunday. You do this together and then you have a bottle of wine, you can go to the pool, you can enjoy your afternoon. This is fun to do. One more thing to do, guys. We're gonna get a large pot. We're gonna put the bottles in there. I think I can only fit 2 large ones in there. Yeah, the 2 large ones are going in. And let's see if the small one fits too. Oh yeah, it does. We're gonna fill up with water. Make sure the water covers the bottles. And we're gonna boil it for about 20 minutes. Now we have the bottles in cold water. Put the fire on And what we do is once it starts boiling, we want to boil it for about 20 minutes. And that's how we seal it, okay? So, see you soon, bottles. Guys, these bottles have boiled for 20 minutes, so it's now time to get them out. Hello, baby. Just be careful not to get burned, okay? Oh, you get it out, you put it there, and you speak. Hello, baby, and welcome, and welcome. I can't wait to eat you. Welcome, baby. Now, even if your bottles are lying down, what's gonna happen is the oil will stay to the top when you put them up, because the oil is lighter than everything else in the bottle, okay? Ah, beautiful. It's the end of the video. You ask yourself, how are you gonna try the sauce? Let me tell you guys, you know how you try the sauce? You eat it with a spoon, or you actually drink it. Why? Because it's straight into your mouth and you can tell if the flavor is good or not. So let's get some sauce out. Not the oil, let's get the sauce. The smell is nice. Mmm, yum. Oh, pure tomato. Pure tomato juice. Mmm! It's nice because it's still nice and warm. Honestly, it does deserve pasta. It's just perfect the way it is. Mmm. Yum. What are you waiting for? Come on, man. Go and buy the tomatoes, make it, and enjoy it just the way I am enjoying them. Thank you so much for watching this episode. I will see you in the next Vincenzo's Plate video recipe. E ora si mangia. Vincenzo's Plate.